Two of the most fierce and feared Disney villains of all time. Instantly recognizable, and both are felines that have murder on their mind and are prepared to do anything to get what they want. Shere Khan from The Jungle Book and Scar from The Lion King. If the two were to come up against each other, who would win? And also, when comparing many other things, who is the strongest and most feared out of the two? Well, let's find out. Before I go ahead, make sure you go over to my Twitter, @brainpilot_, and tweet me what show or movie you'd like me to review next. So without further ado, I'm Brain Pilot, and here is Shere Khan vs. Scar, who would win? I think it goes without saying that this video will contain spoilers and information about the characters and movies, so watch with caution. The appearance. Both big cats have been given the old-school villainous look in their animated form. The expressions and looks that they both give on occasions really do hit home and give the old-school movie villain type of look. When looking at Shere Khan in the animated movie, we see a cat who is given more of a sophisticated, classy, Bond-style villain look and feel. He rarely shouts or expresses his strength, but more in the words that he says and the calm, menacing manner that he has. We know Shere Khan is dangerous just by the way he says what he says, and the words that he specifically chooses. With regards to Scar visually, we see a broken character who has the dark appearance when compared to the red of Mufasa and Simba, automatically making us realize that he is the villain. In terms of his stature, he's thinner than the usual lion, which I feel does show a weakness visually. However, the elongated, thinner face with the squinted eyes and the scar does provide a far scarier and menacing appearance when compared to The Jungle Book's Shere Khan. When looking at the live-action movie, we have two cats that share similar appearances. We have Scar, who I would say is most similar to the animated form in terms of appearance, but it seems we have a more battle-worn version of the character. Scar looks more scary and I'd say vicious when compared to the animated version, which I would say comes across sly and almost like a coward. But this time with Shere Khan, he takes on a completely different form. The damaged eye, sharp teeth, and thick stature with fur really does stand out on screen, and it looks petrifying. The scene in the fire showcased just how dangerous this tiger would be to come up against, and I think it does look better than Scar in The Lion King when it comes to a villain. The expressions felt a bit more out there, and I feel I got more from Shere Khan with the live-action version. I would say in terms of animation, both cats serve their purpose on a relatively equal level, with Scar maybe taking the edge. But by having the live-action remake versions for both available, I would say Shere Khan wins this one. He's far more petrifying, and I feel he looks like he would rip you apart if he had the chance. The voice. The voice of a villain is something that stands the test of time and can arguably be more memorable than the visuals itself. Shere Khan has a memorable voice in the animated movies for certain. When I close my eyes, I can hear the low tone that he adopts and the almost playful articulation of the words that he says. A lot of the time, he's calm and composed when delivering murderous language. As mentioned earlier, the voice is very much an old-school style Bond villain. Jeremy Irons' Scar is most probably one of the best voice acting performances of all time. The tone, articulation, depth, menace, manipulation, and rasp to the voice is like no other. It is a voice that was perfect for the role and can't be topped by any other. We see this comparison in the live-action remake when a new voice actor adopted Scar. I'd say it was subpar and I feel it didn't do the character any justice. In terms of the live-action remake of The Jungle Book, Idris Elba did do a good job at voicing Shere Khan. However, it very much sounded like it was Idris Elba speaking, rather than him playing a character. I'm going to one time reference the movie Mowgli, where Benedict Cumberbatch voiced the tiger. And to be honest, it outperformed Idris Elba's Shere Khan tenfold. Benedict has the low, gritty depth to the voice, and actually incorporated growls into his tone, which embodied the character even more. I feel as though it also adopted some of the playful side that we came to see in the original. Even with that, Jeremy Irons' Scar is a tough one to beat, and I do genuinely believe it's one of the strongest voice acting performances of all time. Scar quite comfortably wins this round. Strength. This is what ultimately makes the villain who they are and deems the power that they hold to their name. We see the pair use the art of manipulation and use their strength in a final battle, which has their own life at stake. We see Scar manipulate the hyenas, which he does successfully, and we see Shere Khan manipulate the wolves. I feel Khan walking into a pack of wolves and brutally taking out their leader by throwing them off a cliff makes a bold statement that Scar never really achieved with the hyenas. We see in the final battle of the Lion King, Scar go face to face with Simba, and to be fair, he does hold his own. However, he does make the foolish mistake of jumping into Simba for him to be thrown off of the cliff and be eaten by the hyenas. We don't see that much strength shown from Scar, as he was defeated relatively easily. With Shere Khan, we see a final battle that really does highlight the strength of the tiger. He takes on Baloo, Mowgli, and the vultures. We see him take out Baloo quite comfortably, only to be defeated by his biggest fear of them all, fire. I don't feel we saw a weakness in Shere Khan's physical strength, but his mental strength and his fear taking over was what let him down in the animated movie. With regards to the live-action movies, Scar's behavior was very similar to what we saw in the animated version. Shere Khan, however, showed even more strength in this version. We saw him take on Baloo, Bagheera, Mowgli, and the wolves, all whilst being amongst his biggest fear, the fire. The mental strength and physical strength shown here far outweighed any of Scar's in the animated version and live-action CGI version. Bearing that in mind, I think it's safe to say Shere Khan wins this round focusing on strength. Overall, taking everything into consideration, I think it's safe to say that the superior villain is Shere Khan. Although maybe not as recognized by fans of Disney movies as much as Scar, I think Shere Khan's strength, appearance, voice, and behavior in all of the iterations we've had provide a more consistent, fearful, menacing villain to watch on screen. I'd also say that if Scar and Shere Khan were to come up against each other in a fight, my money would be on Shere Khan to win it, quite comfortably. Shere Khan is the winner. So, there you have it. Who I think is the superior feline and more superior villain. What do you think? Do you agree with me? Leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.